Hello and welcome back to the video tutorial for the use of the Firebase Auth and Firestore plugin for Bubble. On the last video we covered how to read data from the Firestore and how we can add something as a task here and it will reflect on our front end. Now I will show how you can update data from the Firestore in the documents you have already created. To do that, I put some elements here on the page while off stream. I configured a custom state to show or hide this group right here. So this group shows the task being edited, and what I want to do is to type anything here or something here, and when I click here I want it to edit the test. It's not being done yet. Let's see how it is configured right here. So this check icon, it throws a toast alert that says the task was edited, resets the inputs, and clears the task being edit custom state. Now I wanted to also use the Firestore actions to update a document. And to update this document, what I must provide it as information is the name of the collection in which this document is located and the document ID. This document ID is provided by the element Firestore Doc Field Extractor we used in the previous video, and I can get it from there. So if I get the Firestore Doc Field Extractor task, I can get, aside from the fields I define, I can get the document ID. And then I can set the same fields I did previously, description and due date, and get the values from the inputs, this time from the edit task input and from the edit due date, the time picker here. The types will be the same as before, so it is a date and it is a text. There it is, that's all we need to do. Now if we go back and refresh the page of our app, we have the ability to edit our tasks. So something will be now, let's say another something, and due date will be 28th of July. I click check and there it is, already reflected on our front end, the updated task, and it will be present here on our Firestore too. There it is, another something. So that's how you update a task. Now I want to be able to check, or rather complete, my tasks on the front end too. To do that, there is something I must, or I had to figure out, and I'll show what it is. First, when I get this icon, I want it to be checked when a field I will call done, which is a yes or no field. This field does not exist yet. It's not on my, oh, actually it is. Where did this come from? Oh, I think I clicked the button by accident. Let me just delete this one to see how it is done. So I want it, when the done field, which is field 3, is true, I want this to be checked. So I'll get the value from field 3 from my doc field extractor and say that when it is yes, it will be checked. And when I click this icon, I want to update a document. I had previously done this here just to make the video a bit quicker. I got the tasks collection, the doc ID from the field extractor on this current cell, and I want to set the field done to the field extractor field 3, which is the done field, is no. That will invert its value, so if it is yes, it will be no, and if it is no, it will become yes. And the done field type is of type Boolean. So when I do that and refresh my page, when I check a task here, it will be marked as completed. The only problem is that it is not sorting the way I want it. I'd rather sort it by doing, instead of due date, I want the done ones to be first. To do that, I'll use the sort type number, because Boolean types can be translated to 0 as no and 1 as yes. So if I do that like that, it will show the done ones, or rather the ones with the value 1 in done first, and then the ones with value 0. I hope that was not too confusing, but that's how Boolean types work. So if I do that and refresh the page, nothing will happen. That's because the other tasks I have do not have the done field. So that's something you must watch out for. And to update all my tasks in a way that I can sort them the way I wanted, I created this button that's called Complete All Tasks. And I'll actually change it to be Mark All as Not Completed. I think that's more logical. And I'll start a workflow here and use the Firestore Update a List of Documents action. So here the collection will be the same, tasks. I want to add the done field to be false, or 0, or no. You can choose however you want. I think false is more logical, I mean. So it will be a type of Boolean. That's the most important piece of information you must give here for it to understand what false means. And the document's ID lists I can get not from the field extractor, but rather from the Firestore data tasks. Here we have a state called document lists IDs, in which I can get the list of IDs I want to update. So when I do that, I can refresh my page and mark all as not completed. Let's see this happen here, and voila! Like magic, they are all marked as false, as you can see here, and it is a Boolean type. Now, when I check my tasks, you see that they are automatically sorted for me. So, there you have it. Now we can add more things here. And we have a functional task manager here. I don't need this button anymore. It was necessary only for me to synchronize the database. So I'll delete it, and I'll actually have to change this. Not what I wanted to do. Where it is, start and edit a workflow. I want to add this done field here, and I want it to be false from the beginning. Of Boolean type. Otherwise, I'll always have this problem with sorting. Actually, I just created more things here. Let me see if... Oh, it didn't get the field. That's what I meant in a couple videos ago, that you have to be careful with the fields you create for your table. Maybe you prefer to make a schema of these tables of how they will be for you not to forget and to have something to check every time you are adding these fields here, or rather using them on Bubble. So let's do the Boolean type, false, there you go, and now it should work as intended. So I add another thing. I'm not very creative with these names, and do it here, add, and now when I check it, it should sort accordingly. There you go, and there you go. We can edit this tasks here, and just to sum up, just one last thing to do is to be able to delete tasks. So I'll use this delete task with the trash bin icon, and I use the action from Firestore, delete a document. It works very similar to the update one, but this time we only need to provide the collection name and the field extractor document ID. This should be enough. So let's see. Deleted, deleted, deleted. And we can see these changes reflected on our Firestore. There you go. That's how you update data. On the next videos, I'll showcase a bit of how the authentication part of the plugin works. See you guys there.